Well, I absolutely love Woodinville, and you know, having been here for a long time, I still get excited every day when I drive in the gates. Now it's even more exciting with all the neighbors, all the wineries, fantastic restaurants in the neighborhood. I really enjoy that because 30 years ago, there was very little in Woodinville. It was basically farm country. It seemed kind of peculiar, quite honestly, that Chateau Saint Michel Winery was located 150 miles from the vineyards. And there really was no situation like that anywhere in the world. So a few years ago, I met with the fellow that was the president at the time of Chateau Saint Michel, and I said, "You must have had a great debate about the decision to put it in Woodinville, or what would have been a more natural decision to put it in Prosser or Walla Walla or Yakima or someplace near the vineyards." And I said, "Did you have a big strategic discussion about this? And did your executive staff, you know, debate the pros and cons and look at economic modeling?" And he said, "No, I just wanted to live in Bellevue." So things have really changed since then, because clearly the decision, which was very unique, to put a winery by the population center rather than the vineyards, was somewhat controversial with the purists. But what really it did was create Seattle into a true wine-loving population. We get over 300,000 people a year here, and it really has helped create a wine culture locally here in the Pacific Northwest.
And Woodinville's a really cute town, and so it's kind of tourist-geared and not unfriendly to get around, or you don't have to pay $20 to park or anything like that.
Yeah.
And so it's easy to get around and nice place to come.
30 years ago, many people did not know Washington wines or even take it seriously. And so our job was to go out and evangelize for Washington wine. And so I would often go to the East Coast and I would talk to people about Washington. And when people taste the wine and they understood the story and the latitude that's the same as France, people would really get to understand it. But there were so many people that weren't familiar, and I recall being in a restaurant in Connecticut, and I ordered a bottle of Chateau Saint Michel, and the wait staff came over, and she said, "I'm sorry, but I recommend something else." And of course, I was startled, and I said, "What's wrong?" She said, "Well, I really prefer French wine." And I said, "But what about domestic wine?" And she says, "Well, there's some that are good, but the wine you've ordered comes from Washington. And you know, down at the Capitol, it's very humid in the summer." And I said, "I think you have the wrong Washington." The future is very exciting. I think what's going to happen to Woodinville in the next 10 to 15 years will be spectacular. And I think this idea of Woodinville to Walla Walla will be ingrained, and people will come and take the complete tour that will not only be wonderful in Woodinville, but all throughout the state of Washington.